Right now, some teens commit crime after crime, then they end up immediately back on our streets, released. Why is this happening? I found it's not the judge, it's not the prosecutor, it's not a police officer or a social worker. In fact, most of the time, a human has no say in the matter. It all boils down to a faulty formula utilized by the Florida Department of Juvenile Justice.
Put the guns down now!
On June 1st, two children fired an AK-47, a shotgun and other weapons at deputies for 35 minutes.
We really need to be exposing the Department of Juvenile Justice. It's a failure.
Frustrated, Volusia Sheriff Mike Chitwood pointed to the troubled record of one child and warned, when it comes to serious repeat teen offenders, Florida fails.
They're releasing children who are dangerous.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Think it's just a Volusia County problem? It's not. It happens every single day in our backyard, too. Polk Sheriff Grady Judd will tell you, cops catch them, the system releases them.
This is the arrest records for just these kids. You think we have a problem here?
In just one day in June, 53 juveniles arrested in Polk had priors. And in St. Petersburg, we found a 16-year-old arrested 22 times for carjacking, burglary, and more. Each time, released. A 17-year-old cuffed 10 times in just 4 months. What does St. Pete Police Chief Anthony Holloway think about this?
They understand the system better than law enforcement, better than some attorneys and some judges.
Right now, there's no accountability.
None.
We discovered, right after an arrest, a formula, not a person, determines if a juvenile stays in custody. It's called the Detention Risk Assessment Instrument, or DRE. It's like a score sheet. Juveniles rack up points for their age, severity of crime, and priors. If the DRE score isn't high enough, the teen gets a court date and is then immediately released by the Florida Department of Juvenile Justice, or DJJ. DJJ created the DRE formula. In 2017, the department convened a committee that included police to update it. DJJ says the new DRE, quote, improves public safety through accurate and reliable risk prediction.
What do you think about the DRE system?
Well, I chair that committee, and I don't even understand it. I think we need to, so to speak, start all over again.
We repeatedly asked the DJJ to discuss the formula. I even went to Tallahassee to talk with DJJ Secretary Josefina Tamayo. When I arrived, DJJ insisted the secretary was unavailable.
Is there anyone in this entire building that can talk with us right now?
She's in a meeting.
We do not want children to grow up in prison.
State Senator Dennis Baxley serves on the Criminal Justice Committee. He adopted two children from the system. Baxley believes a balance is needed between accountability and giving kids a second chance.
Is it time to look at DRE and maybe change the system?
I think it is. At the end of the day, whatever we're doing is not interrupting their behavior.
Tonight, in addition to Senator Baxley, we've put the other 8 lawmakers on the Criminal Justice Committee on alert.
We can't have catch and release if we're going to teach juveniles accountability and responsibility.
And that's when I get upset, because then when they turn 18, that's when life hits them, and it's too late.
Florida law allows the DJJ to revise the DRE formula, but it's not required. That's why we're getting lawmakers involved. Meantime, I want to tell the stories of people frustrated with the juvenile justice system. If you're a parent, a police officer, or even a victim of a juvenile crime, please contact me. Masa Saidi, 8 on your side.